All right, Trial Mob, so a few updates from a couple of different brands, including some new Kickstarters and of course some live photos that we got straight out of the Beijing Dream Fest. Now, hopefully we will be getting more photos soon so I can give you guys more coverage on that. I feel like I haven't been able to get as much as I wanted to, but stay tuned. I will be bringing in more throughout the week as it comes in. All right, let's go ahead and break it down. All right, guys, I'm from the Beijing Dream Fair. Here we have a couple of photos of what basically looks like post-production Warhammer Space Marine Primaris, either the Interceptors or the Intercessors. I haven't quite figured out which one is which, and to be honest, I haven't gone on the website to double check, but here they are, and they are looking good. I'll admit that while scaling is still potentially a little small, they are so bulky that when you see them inside of these boxes and you see just how large their guns are, these guys are still pretty damn big, so that is something that I do like. Now, obviously, remember, there are two sets, so both of them were on display, which was very nice. As you can tell, it does say prototype there, but let's be honest, these guys are pretty close to what's going to be the final product, and it's actually kind of nice to see them in different poses, having their arms in different ways. It gives us a good chance to see really what the anatomy of these figures are, because it's really easy to see these guys in nice promotional shots and be like, wow, these things are perfect, but it's even better to see them in a natural pose as what the figure would be when you're just trying to pose them there. Like here, my one fear was that when I first saw the piston on the left, you see how it's aiming kind of up? I was like, oh no, the wrist isn't going to be able to aim down far enough for him to just kind of shoot it directly in a line of sight, right? It's always going to have this weird angled up look. But then if you look to the right, the guy holding the bolter, the actual bolter rifle, his wrist is pointed more down. So, you know, that's what I mean when I say a lot of these pre-production photos sometimes give us a much better view of what the figure is going to be like. Now, I can't help but to notice that there are just a couple of minor differences. Like for instance, on the guy in the middle right here, that right like tubing that's coming out of his pauldron and going down to, I imagine, his fist. I don't remember it being gold, so that might have been something that's different. Maybe not, but again, that is kind of cool to see. And then as you can tell, there is a little bit of glue or some kind of paste that's holding them down. I hope that that's only because they really needed it here and not because they can't stand on their own. They're going to be big, they're going to be heavy, so who knows. But I hope that, again, that's not the case. Now switching over to the other part of Joy Toy, here we have basically a pilot of the new, I believe this is the Fear Mech 5, and let me just tell you, the sniper one from before is definitely still my favorite, but it's really a toss-up between that one and this one. This guy is absolutely incredible. I think he looks great. He has that bigger body, and I like that the overall shape of him is really nice and even, should I say, kind of like, there's not all those holes in the armor for the exoskeleton and all that. It's just a nice, even-looking suit. The only thing I don't like is that he's bare-chested under. I might have that painted in if I end up getting this, or I might just rock it the way it is. It does look cool, don't get me wrong. And like I said, this is a badass looking character, especially with that gun. Now, luckily, we do have real promotional images of the figure itself, and here you can actually see what it looks like. And as you can tell, it's a pretty solid look overall. I like the insignia in the middle of his chest. I love the way the helmet looks. The armor on the body is great. We've seen those legs before. I'm not quite sure if we've seen this chest armor before, but it looks good. I believe the head might be something that we haven't necessarily seen yet, unless it's some of the stuff that we've seen before on those other prototypes with the robotic arms. But he does come with the same, what it looks like, the same pistol. And again, he's bare-chested under. Again, I wish that wasn't necessarily the case. I would just like to see more armor under. So maybe I might have to do a custom of this if it can fit on another body, because remember, it is going to be a bit slimmer because he's bare-chested compared to if he did have an Under Armour. Now here he is with everything on, and as you can tell, this is a much closer close-up of what the actual figure is going to look like with gun and armor in hand, and as you can tell, it is a good-looking figure. I can't even knock this. I really like this look. I hope that they make another one of these, and maybe this time he's fully armored. I really like that look a bit more. I kind of get a Gears of War vibe from this, and I guess I can kind of understand why they would be going for something like that considering the aesthetic. But yeah, this is pretty raw. I could almost see somebody taking this and making an Ares custom from Marvel, because he does kind of have this general look to him. Now as for the Fear Mech 5 itself, damn, this is one big boy, and not only is he big, he's bulky as hell, and man, I want that sniper, and I want this one. If I end up buying these, which is a possibility, I might cave Trial Mob and I might buy a couple. But it's definitely going to be a toss-up between this one and the sniper. Both of these are really up my alley for what I like. And I don't know, it'll just depend on the real estate I have at home to be able to accommodate the size of these figures, because they're obviously just gigantic. you know, just in compared to a lot of the, even a lot of the 1/12 scale stuff that I have, or the bigger Storm collectibles, I'm sure this still towers over them. So it's absolutely ginormous, but I fucking love that, man. This is just so up my alley. This is like what I usually play in the actual Titanfall game. I love the bulkier character, and this one just looks really good. It's bulky, but just not excessively bulky. And then, as you can tell here, he comes with a load of weapons, and he comes with two, I guess, Gatling guns. Are we going to say those are Gatling guns? I'm going to say those are Gatling guns. If somebody would like to correct me in the comment section, by all means, let me know what those are. But damn, does this guy look absolutely hardcore, and I definitely want this one. Now, I do believe this is the Fear Mech 3. I have covered him before, but we did get a few more promotional images, and he does look nice. I love that white color. I'm pretty sure if people have some of the other Joy Toy soldiers that are in this general color, you're going to want this guy. He looks great. He's bulky. He's thick. There's a lot to him, and he does come with his own kind of chain Gatling gun. I'll show you guys right now. And there it is, and I'm not gonna lie, I'm really digging this Gatling look. Maybe it's because I just watched The Mandalorian, not just watched it, but you know, in The Mandalorian there's a heavy Mando, and he's got a gun very similar to this. It is pretty dope, I'm not gonna lie. I've been doing my best to stay away from these mechs, and I feel like up until now I've been able to do a good job of that. But at this point, they're leaving Titanfall behind and starting to make their own stuff, and it's really starting to show, and that's really where my want for these is starting to really kick in. And then here we have them just in a running pose. I'm actually curious if you guys, for those of you who have mechs, if you look at this one, he's literally on the tippy toe of his back foot and on the heel of his front foot, and apparently it holds its body up. For those of you who have these mechs, does it actually do that? Can it actually hold itself up, or is there some trickery here that I'm just not seeing? And then here we just have a close-up of the lower half of the body, some of the detail that we do see there. It looks great, there's no denying that. Right here we have a better gun at the overall size, a better look at the overall size of that chain gun. It's massive. This is bigger than some of them. I'm pretty sure this is about the same height as the mech that I have from Acid Rain, the Revenant Laurel. I'm pretty sure this is the same height, so that just gives you a look at just how absolutely massive that gun is. Now, switching over to Eagle Force Classic. So this is a Kickstarter in the same vein as the Vietnam stuff I've been showing you from Marauder. It's actually very, very reminiscent, very similar. Someone let me know if these guys, like, are in, like, you know, like Toys Alliance has a lot of people under their belt. Are these guys similar to Marauders, Eagle Force? Anyways, they're doing something along the lines of like a 007 type thing. So here we have Savitar the Assassin and everything he's going to come with. He comes with multiple hands, a koala for some reason, an older version of himself, and then two katanas and what looks like an AK-47. This is actually pretty dope. Not really my thing. I probably wouldn't buy this, but I'm sure that there are plenty of people who would like to see this. So coming in Q3 of 2021, so I believe it's already started. So if you want to get your hands on this or back them up, they are already available for support. And then this right here is just a cool little Toys Alliance setup. So basically we have the 88th campsite decor set, which is going to come with a host of different things. I'm not sure if at the point of this video they've already shown us what really is going to come with it, but I imagine it comes with most of this. So this is something that you can add to your walk in the park feature, and add basically this stuff to make it look more like an 88th, you know, sand regiment base, which is really nice. You know, I might buy something like this for future reviews so that I can at least give you more of an ambiance rather than just having the background that I have currently. But this is one of two sets. And then in the second set, we have the 303, which this one would definitely go with your Walk in the Park set, because it basically is based on their 303 Marine Infantry sets. This would definitely match up with all of that. So I know a lot of people make dioramas. I know Kit Lau posts a lot of really nice photography. So this stuff right here would just give you that extra level of realism. And I'm sure that it would really help your photography out to have this kind of stuff in it. Or just in general, you know, for your own diorama set at home. I know that if I ever have the real estate for it, I will be doing something like this. All right, you guys.